Good evening, Jordan.
Hi, Matthew.
With 5 wins out of 5 in the Premier League and reigning European champions, how do you feel you go into this competition? Are you favourites?
I think it's too early to be seeing stuff like that, but for us, we've started the season really well, you know, and we just want to continue that on. We still feel we can improve and still get better. So that's what we try to do. That's what we try to do tomorrow night. Try to give everything and start the campaign off really well.
Dopo 5 vittorie consecutive in Premier League, essendo il campione d'Europa in carica, ci si sente che effettivamente il Liverpool possa vincere ancora questa competizione e si sente favoriti per la vittoria finale. Credo che sia ancora troppo presto per fare questi discorsi, ovviamente ci siamo migliorati e vorremmo continuare a crescere in quanto squadra, ma penso che possiamo farlo già domani sera e dobbiamo dare il massimo per fare i 3 punti.
How much do you reflect on just how much Liverpool and you have progressed in the past year since you were here in Naples last year?
Well, when we came here last year, we didn't perform very well at all. I'm sure the manager will tell you that. I can remember having analysis after that game, and I think we improved a lot since that game, and we used that game to improve a lot. So yeah, hopefully we can, tomorrow night it'll be a different story. Hope performance level is much better. And if that's the case, then we have a better chance and a better opportunity to win, of course. But it'll still be a tough challenge because Napoli are a really good side.
Yeah. And just on Ryan Brewster in the squad, just how impressed have you been with him? And a big moment for him on this flight.
Yeah, Ryan's been really good. Pre-season he was really strong. In training he's been really good. So it gives us another option, of course. We've got a lot of strength in the squad. But he's been doing really well and he just needs to continue in that way. It is important. I don't want to see that being a problem for this team, to be honest. We're always hungry for more. We always want to improve. And we always feel we can do better, of course. So, yeah, last season is last season. Of course, we can take experience from the campaign and the year before as well. So, yeah, we can take that into this campaign, but ultimately we feel as though we're still improving, we can still do a lot of things better. And let's go for everything. Everything's possible again, so we'll want to challenge in every game we play. Maybe, but I feel as though being at Liverpool, everybody wants to beat you anyway, so it's the same for us. We want to beat everybody we play. They want to beat us. So for us it's the same as it always has been, is to give everything in every single game we play. And we know that it'll be tough game tomorrow. They're a great side. But we just got to concentrate on what we can do. And if we perform to the level I know we can, then we'll have a good opportunity to win the game.
We didn't really speak about that yet. We are not... Until Saturday, we were completely focused on Newcastle. And yesterday, we had a light session. Today, we had an important session. And we only spoke about the game and not about the competition because we never made that difference. It's just we fly to, instead of another city in England, we fly to another country. And yeah, it's a city, it's a stadium, and we play their football to win the football game. So, but we all know, and in the meeting, which we will have tomorrow morning, the boys will see it again. We have to learn. Last year we learned from the first game to the second game. It was really important. And this year we have to use that experience because if we don't defend with all we have, no chance against Napoli. They're so strong. I really like watching them. And so that makes it difficult. We don't, how is that? The competition is not really, it's not really something we think about. We got the group a couple of weeks ago. Since then we know who we play. And now we have this day, this actually full day to prepare the game. That's what we try to do. And tomorrow we have to play it.
Jürgen, dopo l'ottimo inizio in Premier League, cosa ha detto di specifico ai suoi giocatori per quanto riguarda l'inizio del percorso in Champions League? Sinceramente non ne abbiamo ancora parlato, fino a sabato ci siamo concentrati completamente sulla partita contro il Newcastle. E, ieri abbiamo potuto fare un allenamento leggero, oggi abbiamo fatto un altro allenamento e abbiamo parlato della partita, ma non abbiamo parlato in generale della campagna europea o del percorso europeo. Abbiamo preso un aereo, ci siamo spostati, abbiamo fatto la trasferta, un altro stadio in cui bisogna giocare, vorremmo vincere la partita. Ma sicuramente conosciamo che l'avversario, domani faremo un incontro la mattina e i giocatori vedranno quello che dobbiamo fare, ma comunque l'anno scorso abbiamo imparato tante cose tra la prima e la seconda partita, dobbiamo fare tesoro di quell'esperienza e se non dovessimo difendere bene sarà molto difficile. A me piace molto vedere giocare il Napoli, ma la Champions League come concetto non è qualcosa di cui abbiamo parlato. Comunque 15 giorni fa abbiamo saputo i nostri avversari tramite il sorteggio, conosciamo quindi gli avversari e cercheremo di preparare al meglio la partita.
Thank you. Brian, one more.
How have you improved? What have been the big differences in 11 months since you came here last?
I don't know exactly, to be honest, because we never, it's not that it works like this and we look how, where are we, and for example between the two games or after that game, I forgot who we played actually in directly after Napoli away game last year. But it was a game where we had to defend as well, really well. So, and we improved in 3 days. Did everything right, what we did here wrong, and kept that going for the rest of the season pretty much. That was a big improvement. So, but am I sure that it never can happen again? Something like that? No, of course not. The boys give me no signs that I have to be, that I can doubt them, I never would do. But still football and with human beings, things like this can happen. So it's not about, we don't, it's not too important to, in a moment we start to, we try to reach the level from last year again, and we don't even know exactly which level it was, to be honest, because nobody can measure it. But we want to be as consistent at least as last year and play, but play our football of this year. Use the skills, use the confidence when it's there, get it back when it's not there, use momentum when it's there, get it back when it's not there, stuff like this. Stay in the game, fight for everything. That's what we want to do. Improvement, we will judge really at the end of the season, but if we then have time to compare it and not the next season is already waiting. So, but it's just do your best, and that's all the time. No, we start with that part. No, we don't feel a burden because I don't know exactly how that should feel, to be honest. It's long ago, 3-4 months, long ago. So, because the question is coming always up, if our teams will now play differently against us, I have no clue, to be honest. I never went in a Champions League season with winning the Champions League the year before, how you know. So we will experience that. But I hope we are prepared for that. Napoli, yes, I think the majority of the teams stayed together. Another very good season for them. Number 3, 4, 5 in a row, pretty much. Maybe not exactly how they wanted, because they are fighting for the league that Juve wins it then at the end, at least so far. So, but a really good season again, and started well in the season, very spectacular. Got in new players, Manolas, right back, a couple of players. So, but kept the majority of the team together. So that makes it really interesting as well. So we are similar. We didn't sign a lot. We signed young boys and kept the team together. So we didn't start new, both of us. So I think we build on what we did last year, and so hopefully at the end it will be better. But for Napoli, in the moment, it looks like they do what they do, stubborn in a very positive way. They play football. They break lines. They have counter attacks. They are creative. They come between the lines. There's so many good football things. I enjoy actually analyze always when I watch Napoli. It's really interesting, but at the end you realize it's not only interesting, it's difficult as well. So it's football, so we are all to defend, so Napoli is to defend as well, but only with hard work, and hopefully we can show that tomorrow. Sorry, again, a long answer.
No problem at all.
It's not a problem. You see, if you would see his system, it's unbelievable.
More of an Italian question, would you take a draw tomorrow?
Oh. So what first part of the question was Lorenzo Insigne. Yeah, we had the same question. And I see him already always smiling before the game in my face. So and then after the game, he has even more reasons. So it's a wonderful player, obviously, pretty quick. So far, it worked out for him, but we're still working. Yeah? We're still working on it that we can defend him, and maybe at one day it will happen. Yeah, and the other thing is, what if I would take a draw? I don't know. That depends massively to the performance. If we are good enough for a draw, I would take it. A lucky draw I would take as well, but if we are good enough to win it, then I want to win. But in the moment, I don't know, so let's play first the game and then I decide which game, which result is the one I want to have for that.
Sì, mi hanno già fatto questa domanda diverse volte in passato, ogni volta che becco Lorenzo Insigne mi ride in faccia e dopo la partita mi ride ancora di più. Sicuramente è un giocatore molto importante, un giocatore molto veloce, stiamo ancora lavorando su come fermarlo, arginarlo e speriamo che un giorno potremmo difenderlo bene. Ma per quanto riguarda la seconda parte della domanda, non lo so, dipenderà molto dalla nostra prestazione. Se dovessimo meritare un pareggio, sì, accetterei il pareggio, accetterei anche un pareggio con un po' di fortuna, ma se dovessimo giocare bene da poter meritare la vittoria, preferirei anche portare a casa i tre punti, ma in questo momento non lo so, giocheremo la partita e poi vi saprò dire.
Okay, last two questions, the gentleman with the microphone and Ingrid from Norway, and then it's just too hot guys, so come on, sorry.
Buonasera mister, Marcello Calvano, Radio Kiss Kiss. A detta di molti, in questo momento il Liverpool è la squadra più forte nel panorama calcistico europeo. È d'accordo con questa definizione che si dà della sua squadra? E poi volevo chiederle se gli spogliatoi ospiti, i vostri spogliatoi, li ha trovati in condizioni ottime, perché la scorsa settimana aveva commentato i video che erano arrivati anche a Liverpool sugli spogliatoi del San Paolo, quelli legati agli ospiti naturalmente. Grazie.
A lot of people are talking up Liverpool as the best team in Europe at this moment in time. Do you agree with that assessment? And secondly, a question about the dressing rooms. Are they in spick span condition? I know there was a video that made its way to Liverpool last week where you commented on the state of the dressing rooms here at the San Paolo.
Oh, we cannot be the best team in Europe because Man City is the best team in the world. So that's the same planet, I heard. And and there are a lot of good teams out there, and you have to prove that constantly. Last year, we were really good. I'm not sure we were the best team in Europe, but we were really good in the right moments. And that's why we won the Champions League. The dressing rooms are brilliant. Or let me say like this, for us exactly the same like last year. I don't see anybody is new, to be honest. So they left the away dressing room obviously like it was. Not sure, that's the plan, and the other dressing room we didn't see. Yeah. So, but if they worked here and the air condition was not on, then I can imagine that they needed a bit longer. Yeah.
Non lo so, no, sicuramente non siamo la squadra migliore d'Europa, perché lo è il Manchester City, la miglior squadra al mondo, no, sinceramente sono tante belle squadre in questo momento, l'anno scorso abbiamo dimostrato di essere se non la più forte d'Europa, ma una delle più forti, ma comunque siamo stati la squadra più forte nei momenti più importanti, quando contava veramente. Per quanto riguarda gli spogliatoi, sì, sono in ottime condizioni, insomma non c'è tanta differenza tra la condizione degli spogliatoi di quest'anno e quello che abbiamo potuto vedere l'anno scorso, quindi forse gli spogliatoi per la squadra ospite non è stato toccato, non lo so sinceramente, non ho visto anche l'altro spogliatoio, ma forse hanno avuto bisogno di più tempo, visto che forse non funziona l'aria condizionata.
Two quick ones to finish, Ingrid and then John Murray. And that sort of thing.
Jürgen, so the weather is very nice and warm and sunny here in Napoli. A bit of a contrast to what it is in Liverpool. And your agent, I believe, spoke to the media recently about you weren't too fond of the Liverpool weather. Could it have an effect on whether or not you would consider to write a new contract with Liverpool?
No, I think he wanted to make a joke, so I have to be serious, obviously. Otherwise, I could make a lot of jokes about the weather, especially sitting here and sweating like crazy. I'm not sure if I could work here, but it was obviously German humor. Nobody got it. The weather was never a reason for me to choose a city, and the weather in Liverpool is not always nice, but especially between, I would say, March and September, October, nicer than you would imagine, and I imagined. But I came in October. and you could sing a song, Don't Move to Liverpool in October, because then it's until March, not too cool. And it was the first 5 months was a bit harsh. So, and then I spoke a lot about the weather, but that's long ago. And now when I speak about the weather or spoke about the weather, it was about the wind, which has an effect on football, but that's not allowed as well in England. So, but it's not a reason as well for me to leave the country. So nothing, I'm completely fine with the weather. Maybe in the moment it's the most healthy weather in the world. We have enough rain, wind is there, so always fresh air. It's pretty much the opposite of this room, actually. So I enjoy that quite often. Nothing in that story. I heard it's obviously was a proper bomb. Yeah? He said something and then they all went for it. He's not only my agent, he's my friend, and friends can of course say what they want. And he did that. And nobody got his joke. So that's how it is.
Qui c'è bel tempo a Napoli, c'è un bel contrasto tra le condizioni meteorologiche a Napoli e quelle a Liverpool. Ultimamente il suo procuratore ha detto che lei non gradisce molto il clima a Liverpool e quindi questo potrebbe portare a un'eventuale partenza da Liverpool, forse il fatto di rinunciare a firmare un nuovo contratto. Credo che lui abbia voluto fare una battuta e quindi in questo caso a me tocca parlare in modo serio. Non ho mai lavorato qui e quindi forse non ce la farei effettivamente perché fa molto caldo in questo momento, ma sì, si tratta semplicemente di una battuta di umorismo tedesco che nessuno ha capito.
Umorismo tedesco, I like that.
Per quanto riguarda il clima, sì, sicuramente non è mai stato un motivo per il quale ho deciso di accettare una sfida, anche se il clima è molto gradevole a Liverpool tra marzo fino a settembre o ottobre, anche se magari non ci si poteva immaginare questa situazione, almeno nel mio caso era così, però io sono arrivato ad ottobre e quindi per i primi 5 mesi è stata molto difficile la situazione, ho avuto 5 mesi difficili perché il tempo è stato molto brutto e perciò ho parlato molto del tempo, ma ormai è passato tanto tempo, c'è anche tanto vento a Liverpool, ma vedo con la stampa inglese non si possa neanche parlare di questo fattore. Ripeto, il clima non è mai stato un motivo per me di cambiare progetto, di cambiare squadra, ma comunque credo che il clima a Liverpool sia ottimale perché comunque abbiamo la pioggia, abbiamo il vento, abbiamo l'aria fresca e a differenza di questa sala di conferenza. E ripeto, è scoppiato un po' un caso con le dichiarazioni del mio procuratore, non si tratta semplicemente di un mio agente, anche un amico, si vede che gli amici a volte non possono parlare, quindi lui ha fatto una battuta poco felice.
Thank you. This has to be the last question, guys. Not a drop of sweat on the translator, but we're dying up here. So, yes, John Murray.
You don't even sweat. That's
it's all under here. Oh,
yeah. It's nice.
You don't want to see me turn
John, jacket. Just to finish off, sorry.
Here we are. As you say, coming into this Champions League season for the first time as the manager of the defending champions, how are you using that as a psychological tool with your players?
No idea how I could use that, to be honest. They know me already. I lost with them 2 finals. I didn't change a lot in that moment, actually, and came in and tried to hide myself in a meeting room because we lost the final, and now I don't come in and celebrate like this. So I don't know exactly. We used that all together. We made that experience together. The experience of losing finals is not the nicest thing in the world, but it's important as well. Can be important. You don't need it, really, but it can be important. We use it in a good way, and experience to win it is just nicer. But on the other side, we know that it doesn't mean anything. So really, you cannot imagine how normal it is to carry on after the celebrations, all the private things. It's so easy to carry on normal if you have the right character. If you go nuts and start taking drugs and drinking and driving different cars or whatever and leave your missus at home because you think now I'm the Champions League winner, then I can't help you. But we are not like this. We want to create more stories to remember in the future and not only this one. So we cannot stick to that. It's really obviously difficult. I'm not sure what Zinedine Zidane answered 3 years ago when he won it again and again and again, that probably they just tried to do it. And we have no clue if we have any chance to do so. We had, not to forget, last year, very difficult group stage. We lost all the away games. We tried to change that. at least this year, and then we will see what it's good for. But I have no idea how I could use the fact that I won the Champions League with the boys, and so I didn't even think about it.